This video is the second part of my full body workout, Shacking the Muscles, episode 2. So I recorded this video on January 23rd, 2017, after I did my one body part per week. So you could look back on some of my videos. I think I post most of them already. The reason I did this mini full body workout is because during my one body part per week, some muscles were and have been resting for a while. So the week after I did all the major muscle groups, like for instance, chest the first week, legs the second week, back the third week, and on the fourth week, I was only doing cardio and abs. So pretty much all of my body, all the major muscles were resting. So once I was done with these muscle groups, I did not touch them again. So throughout each week, especially cardio and abs week, all the muscles were resting. So this mini full body workout was necessary to shock the entire body. Believe me, it did its job. The plan was to do this mini full body at least 3 days within the week. The second day, Wednesday, January 25th, I barely did all the routines that I wanted to do. I did them, but I was very sore. My Instagram page has pictures and videos of me using the AccuRelief thing. It's something I got for Christmas. So it's really good for muscles. So I was using it pretty much throughout the week after I did that mini full body workout. My quads, my hamstrings were sore. I ended up doing only 2 days mini full body instead of three. I wanted to, I knew I wasn't gonna be able to do the third day because it was Chinese New Year. So I usually do one day I work out, one day I rest, one day I work out and rest. So I alternate. So the third day was gonna be on a Friday, which was Chinese New Year. But anyway, during the mini full body workout, my plan was to do upper, which was chest, then lower, legs, then back, you know, upper, lower, upper again. Lastly, I will throw in some biceps and tricep at the end after I did all the major muscle groups. That was the plan for the mini full body for this video. After I did most of my upper workouts, which is on the first video. So I realized that people were starting to show up at the gym, and I didn't want when I finished all the major muscle groups and I will come back to this machine where I did all, the cable machine where I do most of my exercises. I needed to do some of my biceps and triceps. So when I realized people were showing up, I said, you know what, let me just do the biceps there. And then I just go and continue my workout and do my legs. So I did my arm workout instead. Then I went on to do my legs and lastly my back. So this video is the remainder of the January 23rd workout. I hope my video helps or give you some ideas on how to approach some of your workout. You can't go to the gym and do the same thing all the time. Sometimes you have to create some stuff to motivate you to go to the gym. So this was a way for me to switch things a little bit. So it is good to switch your workout once in a while. And that is what I did here. I hope you enjoyed the video. So, no more talking. Thanks for watching. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
finished the leg extension and the hamstring curl. I did seven sets, 12 repetitions for each. And by the time I get to the leg press, I wasn't sure I'll be able to do a 245-pound plate. So I started with a 50-pound, pretty much, 225-pound plate, just in case I wasn't able to do it. So once I started, you know, I have everything set up, my timer and everything. So I'm taking my time, making sure I'll be able to do the presses, you know, resting a little bit. And I was like, oh man, will I be able to push this? It was kind of funny. You know, when you think something is going to be heavy and when you push it and it's not, that's what happened here. I was like, okay, I think I could do the 245-pound plate. So I just remove it. I was like, I'm not even going to waste my time with this. So I put the 45-pound plate. So pretty much after I put the 245-pound plate, you know, I reset, I collect my thought, and I said, okay, let's get going. Yeah, I started, you see, I made sure my lower back is firmly against the pad, because I still have problem with my lower back. But I was like, you know what, I'm not gonna, at least I could sit on this and then, you know, rest my back. So after I did that, I was like, God damn it, why did I keep the pad so far away? Because I have to keep track of my count of my sets. Otherwise, once I get to after three or four, I sort of forget how many sets I'm doing. So I had to keep the thing close by. Again, took a couple break, about 20 to 40 second rest time. Usually the first two, three sets, I could take, you know, minimum rest. But once I get to four, five, oh my God, it burns. And sometimes I miscount, and I'm sure some of you, if you see some of my other videos, you know I miscount a couple of my routine. Okay, put the timer. I sort of cheat a little bit with the timer here. I wrote my set first, then press the time. That's the way I sort of cheat a little bit. Usually I should have pressed the timer first, then write whatever it is that I'm doing. So I stole about maybe 2 or 3 seconds. So now I'm doing the next set. Get myself ready, and I believe this is the third set. And if you see my butt is a little bit high, the reason I do that, when I sit against, you know, the pad, my butt is against the lower pad, for some reason my back hurt a little bit, so I have to push the back rest as high as possible. Actually, it's at the max. It cannot go any higher than that. So in order for me to accommodate a little bit more, I guess, to adjust whatever pain I might be feeling, when I had to adjust I have to move my butt away from the sitting pad. So now I'm doing the next set. I believe this is four. I wasn't even counting. I believe, I think I would 12 repetitions. I think I did 10. It's supposed to be 10 repetitions. Okay, I took a couple second rest. So I try not to fast forward a little bit, at least you guys could see my rest period, my rest time. So you start the next set. I walk a little bit, and sometimes I realize when I'm just stretching a little bit. Look at me dangling my legs. I realize sometimes when I walk, you know, to, you know, stretch a little bit, to get back on the seat, it makes me more lazy. Sometimes I prefer to just sit there. When I'm doing those seven sets like that, I prefer to just sit there and do it really quickly. You know, once I walk around and when I know it's almost time to get ready for the next set, I become so lazy. So sometimes I just sit. I don't walk around. I was exhausted. Look at this. I'm cheating there. I took a couple seconds again. This is one way, I guess, when you guys don't have time to work out. Let's say you have maybe 45 minutes. This is the best way to get your workout in. You know, you do, you know, maybe three sets of whatever. You took as little rest as possible and you do it really quickly. And today is actually, what's today? January 31st. And I did this workout a week ago. So today, actually, I did legs. And I'm going to take clips from this to talk about my workout today because I did not record anything, but I wrote everything that I did. So most likely I'll be taking clips from the 23rd, January 23rd workout to sort of explain what I did on January 31st. And I knew I had the clips, that's why I didn't bother recording. Plus the gym was kind of packed. When it's packed like that, it's kind of hard to record. So pretty much that was the leg press. And you see my heart rate, 125, and what is it? I think it was 499. Once I was done with the leg press, for some reason, every time I need to do the right grip lat pull down, somebody was using it. So I decided to do the one arm. This is just... I went to the other machine, the lat pull down, the two handle, and I said, you know what, since I took a couple breaks after I did my upper body earlier during the day, which is in the first video, I said, let me do one arm lat pull down first, and I did both arms, I think. I don't remember, you guys could count how many sets, how many reps that I did, but technically it was mostly to warm up my shoulder joints a little bit, but I really wanted to do the Y grip. So I started with this, and most of all of my workout on that day, the legs in particular, from what I remember, was seven sets of everything with minimal rest. So I'm doing the close grip, and I did seven sets, and I believe it was 12 reps. You guys could count. Now it's February 1st. I'm continuing editing this video. I did some yesterday. Probably 3 days I'm editing. I've been so busy with the kids and stuff like that, so I don't have time. So I'm back at it again. I wasn't planning on doing a lot of voiceover, so I had to watch some of the thing that I did and to continue the next to pretty much complete the video. So I believe I did 7 sets with between 20 to 40 second rest, and I think it was either 10 or 12 repetitions. So pretty much I will not do any more voiceover. That's it. You guys could watch and enjoy the video. And I believe I'm gonna have a third video on that day for, what is it, January 23rd. Because I record couple stuff and I didn't wanna put everything in one video. So let me see, when I got home, I think after this, I went to the supermarket, I did some stuff. So yeah, there's gonna be another video as a continuation to this one. So thanks for watching. We'll be right back.
came from the gym, and not exactly the gym, I just came from the supermarket. And right after the supermarket, I went to the library, dropped some stuff, books that my son already read over the weekend. So, my heart rate is still up. There it is. Let's see how much I burn. I left the watch running, even though I finished workout, because I walked to the supermarket. I use it as some form of a cardio, because my heart rate was still up. And actually, all together, I burned 800 so far, because it's still going, 818 calories. So that information, I'm gonna put it in the I'm gonna log it in. So I went to the supermarket to get.
Sorry for cutting so abruptly, but there's so much to talk about, and I decided to make a third video instead of putting everything in one video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.